Dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, praise be to Him, sent to us His most beloved of all His creation to be our Rasul al-Nabi, our messenger and prophet, with the greatest message, the message of Islam, that is described by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ صَالِحَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. I have been sent to perfect moral character and good conduct. And in the Arabic expression, there is nothing similar to it in the English. When he said إِنَّمَا, that means this is for the only reason I have been sent. With a confirmation, indeed, I have been sent only to perfect moral character and good conduct. And if that is the case, then morality and good conduct should be in all the aspects of our religion, in our dealing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, and with all humanity in whatever action we do, because this deen is also interaction. So husnul khuluq, the good conduct which is upon moral principles, that is the core and the aim of the message of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, about which he said, the closest to me in the day of judgment of all of you are those who are the best in moral character and good conduct. The closest. And who of us in the day of judgment would not love and like and work for to be the neighbor in Jannah of our beloved sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. If you want to be his neighbor in Jannah, closest to him, then your way to that is morality and good conduct. And morality and good conduct, in fact, started from La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, this word and testimony of faith, as a pillar of Islam to the Hajj. And all the acts of worship, in fact, fall within the boundary of morality and good conduct. Also, from La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah to removing any harmful object from the path of people. And here that are the shu'ab al-iman, the branches of faith. The first is La ilaha illallah, and the least is when you remove harmful things from the way. And we need to implement morality and good conduct in all the aspects of the deen. And today we will just talk about La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. So what should be then our moral conduct with our God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who created us out of love? Wallahi, He created you out of love. And then He provided for you. He didn't leave you in this dunya so as to wander around without provisions. And in heaven is your provision and what you are promised. And by the Lord of the heavens and the earth, it is hot, it is the truth, equally as you talk. Real. So the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is more real than our physical reality. So if that is the case with our Lord, our great Lord, how should we then pay Him back? Can we, in the first place? Shall we just ignore Him No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't demand from us that much. He said in the Holy Quran, what Allah would do with punishing you and putting you into suffering if you are faithful and you are thankful. Two demands. Shakartum wa amantum. And the iman is love. Iman in reality, in essence, is love. So our relationship with him, out of courtesy, out of character and good conduct, we have to love him. And wallahi, we have every reason to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The one who loved us before we even are anything, before our creation, and the provisions day in and day out. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided you even with your mother and your father and your family and your children and food and everything. Doesn't he deserve a thank you? La ilaha illallah. Doesn't he deserve a thank you? That is what you need to do it from your heart, from the bottom of your heart, with that devotion to him. Acknowledging the bounty, like Sayyidina Dawood alayhi salam. Dawood alayhi salam, whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded him in the Holy Quran, اعملوا آل داود شكرا وقليل من عبادي الشكور. Work in gratitude over the family of Dawood. Indeed, few of my servants are the grateful. Dawood alayhi salam did never leave gratitude from that day. However, he couldn't give the due thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in that state of humility, state of helplessness before this great Lord, he said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my Lord, how can I be grateful to you even if gratitude is a bounty from you? When I say Alhamdulillah, this is a bounty from you that deserves Alhamdulillah. Endless. To that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to him, O Dawood, right now you are grateful to me. Ash-shukr. And then, also we shouldn't exclude Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from our good conduct. He is part of faith. La ilaha illallah Muhammadun Rasulullah. You will never have faith before you utter and believe in this testimony. Moreover, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no one of you truly believe. Let me give you the exact Arabic in English. No one of you believe until I become more beloved to him than himself, his wealth, his parents, his family, his children, and all humanity. Scholar said, no one of you truly believe. In fact, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no one of you believe until. So our doorway to him is his love. And also we have every reason to love him. The one who brought us the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the message. And he became the role model for us, the exemplar of Islam. And devoted all his life for it. So that we enjoy the connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He deserved the love. And wallahi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created him in a way that you have nothing but to love him. the beauty of form, the beauty of character, the beauty of interaction. Everything of him is absolute perfection and beauty. صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. However, asked رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم, Allah سبحانه وتعالى mentioned in the Holy Quran regarding a paying back if we can. When he said, قُلْ لَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ أَجْرًا إِلَّا الْمَوَدَّةَ فِي الْقُرْبَى. Say to them, O Muhammad, I'm not asking you any price for this message except being kind to my family. However, let me say it. Wallahi, as an ummah, we ignored Rasulullah for quite a long time. Unfortunately. Wallahi, as an ummah, hardly sometimes we even remember Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Get to know, wallahi, without him, we are nothing. He is our role model. He is the one we take our deen from A to Z. وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. Whatever the messenger of Allah give you, take it. And from whatever he forbid you, abstain. Stop. And this entirety of the deen from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah, said to his special students, ask me whatever you want, and I will give you the answer from the book of Allah. And one of his clever students, he asked him a question that the answer is from the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Imam said to him, he asked about what is the ruling of killing like a mouse while in a state of ihram. He said to him, this is Shafi'i now, وَمَا أَتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. Whatever the messenger give you, take it. And from whatever he forbid you, stop and abstain. So dear brothers and sisters, let me remind you, sometimes we may be distracted by the terms which are used in jurisprudence, in fiqh, and then we do some injustice to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. These scholars, mashallah, they had their time and this is their specialty. They classified the acts of worship into fard, that is obligatory, and sunnah, that is required, but at a lesser obligation, and so on. However, I don't want you to bother a lot with this. Yes, ask about your deen, however, the most important is how seriously are you going to take it. That is the bottom line. Because there is something dangerous there. Among the classifications, they may say to you that the fard is that act of worship that you have to do as an obligation, and if you do it, you will be rewarded. If you didn't, you will be punished. As to the sunnah, if you do it, you will be rewarded, but if you didn't, you will not be punished. And this, in fact, affected a lot of us. Sometimes, someone may come and pray the Isha, being very tired and exhausted, and we say, I did the fard, now just let me relax. But get to know, that is the greatest faith. Because the taking seriously the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam should be as he dictated, as he stated, عُضُّوا عَلَيْهَا بِالنَّوَاجِزِ. Bite hard with your moral teeth upon it. Don't let it go. Moreover, if we have the love in our heart for him, his sunnah will not be that burden. It will be our pleasure. And one more thing before we pray inshallah is that from the husnul khuluq, from the morality and good conduct with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is that we have to revere him, respect him, and remember him with salah alayhi as Allah dictated. Salatu ala al-Nabi or prayer upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. However, we have a problem. And this problem, in fact, is all over our books. Sometimes you may find reports in the interpretation of the Holy Quran or the text of Hadith or the seer, the biographies and so on, history, that may report about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in a way that conflict what Allah said about him. Allah said about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. You are upon a great moral current. And then you find the report that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was not like that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنٌ. Indeed, in the Messenger of Allah, you have the best example to follow. However, you may also come and find that sometimes even in delivering the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they report to us that he made some mistakes and he made some errors. Get to know, this is not your Rasul. If Allah said that, we will never take anything that is going to degrade, belittle, or insult his essence, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wallahi, I'm saying this out of love for you and out of love for him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Since, if somebody is going to come in the day of judgment with animosity, hatred, belittling to his neighbor, to his, even his neighbor, the non-Muslim, he will be among those who did not come back to Allah with a sound heart, qalb salim. So if that is the right of your neighbor, how about the right of your Nabi, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So wallahi, let us keep away from belittling our beloved or believing that he is less than the perfection of humanity at its apex. No one ever will be close to him in knowledge, character, and akhlaq ever. وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep our hearts sound and fill our hearts with the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. And inshallah, in the coming khutbah, we are going to discuss the relation of prayer to Husnul Khuluq as well as all the other acts of worship. Allahumma inna nas'aluka fi hadha al-yawm al-khabeeth an la tad'alana dhanban illa ghafarta wa la hamman